بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Our case today is very interesting. Common Arab port, Saudi port, Jordan port, Egyptian port related to metabolic disorder. We'll see our case here. Presented to ER, 3 weeks old male presenting to emergency department with vomiting and alterations of the mental status and acidosis. This is the clue in these questions. Alteration in the mental status with acidosis, what additional laboratory test should be included in your evaluation? So this case, patient presented in ER, vomiting, alteration of conscious level, acidosis, critically ill patient, you have three differential diagnoses. Just only three differential diagnoses. The first, this is the common. First, sepsis, 3 weeks, sepsis. This is the first differential diagnosis, sepsis. Second, sepsis. The third, sepsis. After that, cardiac. The third, it will be metabolic disorder. So you have to rule out late onset neonatal sepsis if there is any cardiac disorder and important error of metabolism. So this case present with, because the important error of metabolism, it will be non-specific symptoms. Can present with CNS, cardiac, or GI, or respiratory symptoms. But there is acidosis and alterations of the mental status. Also, it will give you clue about the important error of metabolism, because the diagnosis of metabolic disorder need high index of suspicion, and we need detailed history from the family. There is family history of similar condition, and you have to be in the hospital with screening baby for newborn screening or newborn spots. So we'll see what is the investigation you need to request it in this case. A, ammonia level, yes, for sure. We said sepsis and cardiac and important error, so you have to request for ammonia and lactate. B, cortisol level. Why you send the hormonal study? Did you think about the congenital adrenal hyperplasia? It could be, but I have to request only one hormone. Should be panel 17 hydroxylase and another hormonal panel for congenital adrenal hyperplasia. Serum acetone. D, thyroid function test. Actually, the most important, it can be all, but actually we need the most, can be correct, but the mean, we need the most correct one. It can be possible, but we need the most correct one. So it will be the ammonia. We need the ammonia. Ammonia and lactate, but here it's written ammonia, so we need ammonia to rule out important error of metabolism. So the critical ill infant, the differential diagnosis, it will be sepsis, cardiac, and metabolic. Because we need high index of suspicion. So what types of important error of metabolism? You have all protein disorder, carbohydrate disorder, fatty acid disorder. Protein, it will be amino acidopathies, because the amino acid is affected, organic acidemia, or urea cycle defect. This is related to protein disorder. Amino acidopathies, organic acidemia, and urea cycle defect. What about the carbohydrates? It will be defect in the galactose, glucose transport, glycogen, and fructose. What about the fatty acid oxidation? It will be medium chain or long chain or very long chain. We call it VLCAD, very long chain acyl CoA dehydrogenase deficiency. So medium chain acyl CoA dehydrogenase deficiency, and also long chain 3-hydroxy acyl CoA dehydrogenase deficiency, because the common, it will be VLCAD, very long chain acyl CoA dehydrogenase deficiency. So how to approach for case of important error of metabolism? You have to take history, clinical examination, you have to put your impression, you have to extract initial lab, then we'll go for the secondary lab, primary lab and secondary lab, then you have to treat. There is emergency treatment and the ward treatment, or PICU or NICU treatment. So what is the clue from the history? It will tell you this patient having or highly suspicion of important error of metabolism. The first, actually the age of the patient, it will be normal infant birth, usually term, and the illness presenting within first 48 hours, or can be early, can be late. when actually it will be after introduced the protein, after introduced the protein for the baby. So the baby, it will be compromised, lead to metabolic decompensation or metabolic crisis. It will present with metabolic crisis. Family history, for sure you have to take detailed family history about, because there is evidence of consanguinity, because the most of the metabolic disorder, it will be autosomal recessive, so I have to take a history of there is any neonatal disease, there is or unclear etiology of the disease, there is history of child with neurological deteriorations, there is history of multiple miscarriage, there is consanguinity or no consanguinity. It will give you clue or high index of suspicion for important error of metabolism. Clinical presentation. So finish the history, then the clinical presentation, then the examination, then the laboratory, then the impression, then will genetics and all of this. So clinical presentation, patient can present with CNS symptoms, 3C. Confusion, convulsion, coma. Confusion, convulsion, coma can present with seizure. Yes, can present with seizure. Same our case here, alteration in the conscious level, decreased level of conscious level. Confusion, convulsion, coma. This is CNS symptom, can be cardiac symptoms, because some metabolic disorder it will present with cardiomyopathy, and some can present with GI, can be vomiting, it will actually excessive vomiting. It also it will give you clue this patient having metabolic disorder, can be lethargy, coma, seizure, change in the tone or reflect, can be present with hypotonia, even can present with hepatosplenomegaly, can be present with dysmorphic baby like Zerwiger disorder, can present with cataract like galactosemia, it will be associated with cataract and E. coli sepsis, gram-negative sepsis with galactosemia, because non-glucose reducing substance in the urine, you can detect this case. So how to approach for important error from the place? History and also the family history, it's very important. Consanguinity, there is a neonatal disease, there is miscarriage, there is history of neurological deteriorations. Then the clinical presentation can be presented with either CNS manifestation, confusion, convulsion, or seizure, or lethargy, or hypotonia, or cataract, or can present with dysmorphic features, or GI, poor oral intake, or vomiting, can present with cardiac manifestation. The symptoms, it will be non-specific for the important area of metabolism. So because the symptom is non-specific, so we need high index of suspicion, and we need also a metabolic screen or to screen this baby, because the symptom is non-specific. So we need high index of suspicion from the clinician, and we need laboratory, this is we call it a newborn screen for such cases, because it's preventable, What is the clinical presentation? This is a clinical feature, can be CNS, can be cardiac, can be GI, can be respiratory symptoms, can be presented with deterioration of the conscious level, lethargy, seizure, coma. This can present with shock, can present with poor perfusion, can present with vomiting, can present with poor feeding, like sepsis-like picture, can be present with sepsis-like picture, metabolic-like picture, cardiac-like picture, respiratory-like picture. Is no specific symptoms for important metabolism. So we need high index of suspicion and newborn screen. So the differential, this is how to actually treat this patient in emergency department, or the patient is presented with critically ill patient, shocked patient, so acidotic patient, immediately what are going to do? You have to stop all enteral feeds to eliminate the protein or galactose or fructose, because we don't know this is the metabolic disorder related to the protein, amino acidosis or organic acidemia or urea cycle defect or glucose galactosemia or fructose deficiency, or we don't know. So you have to eliminate all the feed or eliminate all the enteral feed to eliminate the protein, the triggering factors. Two, you have to change the IV fluid to D10. We need to stop the catabolic state and improve the anabolic state. So the anabolic state, you have to give glucose, and to stop the catabolic state, you have to eliminate all the triggering factor, the protein, galactose or fructose. So I have to improve the anabolic state to give glucose, D10, and you have to deliver glucose infusion rate 8 to 10 milligram per kg per minute, and discontinue IV lipid even if the insulin is required to maintain the blood glucose. So the first thing, you have to eliminate the triggering factor. This is the catabolic state. You have to remove the protein, galactose and fructose. Then you have to give anabolic to improve the anabolic status, to give glucose detain and to keep the glucose infusion rate between 8 to 10 milligram per kg per minute. The third, you have to treat any significant acidosis. If there is pH less than 7.22, you have to treat the acidosis. And the fourth, you have to eliminate the toxic metabolites. The toxic metabolites. How to eliminate this toxic metabolite depend on the ammonia level. If ammonia less than 500 ml, you have to give sodium benzoate or phenyl acetate, or this it will help to eliminate the ammonia. If more than 500, so you have to go for hemodialysis. You have to go for hemodialysis, and for sure you have to consult genetics, metabologist. It will help you to direct the management. So you have to stop the breakdown or the catabolic state to eliminate all the feed, whatever is protein, galactose, fructose. Second, you have to build up the anabolic state. You have to give glucose and to keep the glucose infusion rate between 8 to 10 milligram per kg per minute. The third, you have to treat. There is acidosis, you have to treat acidosis. There is hyperammonemia, you have to treat hyperammonemia. And don't forget to consult the genetics and metabolic metabologist to actually guide you and direct you about the management. The home message in this case or in important metabolism: first, individually rare. This is actually the metabolic disorder. It's rare. However, account of 20% of diagnosis in sick full-term infant. It's one of the differential diagnosis of critically ill patient, shocked patient, sick patient. So you have to put it in your differential diagnosis: sepsis, cardiac, then metabolic. Any sick patient, critically ill patient, shocked patient, you have to put it in your list, but not put it in the first, because actually it's almost 20% of the diagnosis. So you have to put sepsis, then cardiac, then important error of metabolism, unless the history suggestive or high index of suspicion, it will give you clue. This is maybe what will be the priorities for the important error based on the history, or there is index case in the family. So the first thing, it's rare, but you have to put it in your differential diagnosis: sepsis, cardiac, and important error, because there is 20% of diagnosis of the sick full-term infant presented with important error of metabolism. Second, the symptom is non-specific. You see that the non-specific presenting symptoms. So if this non-specific symptom, what are going to do? You have to require high index of suspicion. We need good clinician, vigilant eyes. We need vigilant eyes, high index of suspicion. And also, if your hospital depend on the newborn screen, you have to look for the newborn screen. The third, many are treatable with early recognition. So early treatment, actually it will improve the outcome. Early treatment, it will improve the outcome. The fourth, common in certain population. The fourth, common in certain, what is the meaning of common in certain population? You have to know in your area. Say I'm working in Egypt, I'm working in other areas, I'm working in a specific area and a specific population. This disease is common in Abu Arab. This common in Ali, this common in Ahmed family, Mahmoud family, common in Rashidi, common in Pahlavi, based on the family. Some disease, it's common in the family. So you have to recognize the family and the diseases in the family. And there is map now for if each family depend on the country. So common in certain population. You have to ask, what is your family? Oh, this is Ahmed, this is Mahmoud, this is Ali, this is Rashidi. So by the name of the family, you can detect what is the kind of metabolic disorder in this family. Fifth, detailed knowledge of the biochemical pathway is not necessary to treat patients during the initial evaluation. So you have to treat the emergency first, ABC. After the ABC, and you eliminate the triggering factor, and you give anabolic to build the anabolic state of the patient by giving dextrose. After that, you can go for the pathway of the biochemical pathway, but don't make it as initial thought or initial actually to take detailed about it. You have to treat first, then you have to look for the cause. The fifth, the sixth point, important to know which important metabolism is tested on the newborn screening in your state. You have to know which state you are. I'm in Egypt, I'm in other countries. So what is the newborn screen is doing? What, how many disease in the newborn screen? What is common in this family? What is common here in this area? You have to know everything about this. Then after that, you go for emergency management. Emergency management, you have to stop oral feeds. You have, this is stop the triggering factor. This is the catabolic state, the breakdown state. Then you have to give the anabolic to support the anabolic to provide D10 and keep the glucose infusion rate between 8 to 10 milligram per kg per minute. And you have to correct the acidosis and the hyperammonemia. So you have to stop the catabolic state. You have to improve the anabolic state. You have to treat acidosis and hyperammonemia and you have to send the initial screening lab ABG, ammonia, lactate, glucose, electrolytes, liver function, and also the bilirubin. Some metabolic diseases will present with cholesterol like Zellweger and the CBC and differential count. And you have to consult metabologist and genetist. And even in the cases of the early neonatal, this is diagnosis is important for family planning. So you have to diagnose to counsel the parents. This is parent counseling, to tell them this is case. You have to diagnose the disease, or you have to diagnose the case to tell them this is disease related to the protein, or related to glucose, or related to fat. This is amino acidosis, or galactosemia, or is related to fatty acid oxidation. It will help during the counseling to know even the second baby or the mother is, or the parents is there is planning for next baby, to know, to tell them there is possibility of the 25%, because all most or the majority of the metabolic disorder will be autosomal recessive. There is possibility for the next pregnancy, 25% from the cases it will be present by same. So the home message, the key point is that one, first of the all, you have to put the inborn error of metabolism in your differential diagnosis in sick full term infant. Sepsis, cardiac, and inborn, because there is 20% it will diagnose in sick, shocked, or critically ill full-term infant. This is the first key point. The second key point, the symptoms of the inborn infant metabolism is non-specific. What I'm going to do, you have to depend on your high index of suspicion or the your newborn screen. The third, many of the metabolic disorders, it will be treatable. So early treatment, it will improve the outcome. The fourth, common in certain population, you have to know the families. This is Ahmed family, this is Muhammad family, Rashidi family, Balawi, Atawi, whatever the name, you have to know it, because it will be famous metabolic disorder in a specific family. So you have to know common in certain population. And the fifth, you have to know the detailed knowledge biochemical pathway is not necessary to treat patients during the initial evaluation. Don't look for the pathway. This is hypoglycemia, ketotic, non-ketotic. This is metabolic acidosis, high iron gap with normal iron gap. Don't actually waste your time for detailed knowledge of the biochemical pathway. You have to go directly to the treatment. What is the treatment? Stop the catabolic state, support the anabolic state, treat acidosis, treat hyperammonemia, call the genetist. Call the genetist or metabologist. See, the sixth one, important to know that which important area of metabolism test in newborn screening in your state. So you are sending the newborn screen. You have to know how many disease in this newborn screen. For example, in our hospital, 17 disease. You can diagnose or detect 17 disease from newborn area of metabolism, like congenital hyperplasia, like amino acidosis or galactosemia, and all of this. You have to know what test you have in your hospital and how many disease you can detect it in this newborn screen. The fifth, the emergency management. Emergency management five. First, stop catabolic. How to stop? Eliminate all the feed, whatever is protein, glucose, galactose, or fructose. Then you have to support the anabolic state. You have to give glucose and keep glucose infusion rate between 8 to 10 milligram per kg per minute. The third, you have to treat the acidosis. And the fourth, you have to treat the hyperammonemia based on the ammonia. Ammonia is less than 500. You have to treat sodium benzoate or phenyl acetate. And if more than 500, you have to go for dialysis. And don't forget to consult the genetist and metabologist. It will direct you and help you. At the last, Even in cases of early neonatal disease, diagnosis is important for family planning. So don't think, why I'm going to diagnose this is protein disorder, it's amino acidosis or organic acidemia or urea cycle. Or this related to glucose disorder, this is galactosemia, fructosemia, whatever, or this is related to fatty acid oxidation. It's very important for family counseling, for family counseling. It's very important for family counseling and for outcome, to help actually in the outcome, even in management. It will help you in management. So you have to reach to diagnosis, to counsel the parents, to know the outcome, to know which management you are going to treat. But the emergency management, this five, the emergency management: stop catabolic, support anabolic, treat acidosis, hyperammonemia, consult genetic and metabologist. ومن أحياها فكأنما أحيا الناس جميعا. شكرا, سلام عليكم.